By the end of this video, you'll have a general idea of what national income statistics are and how they can be used to measure economic growth and living standards. National income statistics measure a country's output with respect to goods and services. They are used to determine the level of growth for the economy. Growth in an economy is measured by the increases in output. Economic growth can indicate how living standards have improved over time. Typically, as more goods and services are produced and sold, greater economic activity is taking place. This implies that higher incomes are earned, and thus the material living standards rise as well. A great example that is often given in economics classes is that of China in the 1980s versus China today. In 1980, China's economy was valued at $306 billion. In 2019, it was measured at over $14 trillion. In 1981, 81% of the country's population was in absolute poverty. In 2015, that number had fallen dramatically to 0.15%. So it's clear that there is a strong relationship between economic growth and the improvement in living standards. National income statistics also help us compare the relative performance of economies as well. Let's look at two countries to see how national income can be used to compare them, country A and country B. In year one, country A has a national income of $100. Country B is much larger with a national income of $500. In year two, country A's national income rises to $125, whereas country B's economy rises to $525. Both economies have increased in size by $25. However, as a percentage of their original state in year one, country A's growth rate is much higher at 25%. Country B's economy is already large, and thus the $25 increase only results in a 5% increase. Of course, there are many factors to consider beyond national income to determine what is happening in these economies, but it gives us a good starting point. In the next video, we're going to learn about GDP and other measures of national income. For now, you should be comfortable with national income statistics and how they may be used to measure economic growth and living standards. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below and let's try and answer them together. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.